A team from UNRA, led by the Kabale Station manager, Engineer Alison Avenawe, arrived at the scene with machinery for roadworks. They blamed the traffic police for failing to implement the directive to halt traffic from the affected section of the road. However, the traffic police that was deployed at the scene to enforce safe movement did not stop the vehicles from using the damaged road, hence putting the lives of the road users at risk. Abenawe said that they were disappointed to find vehicles moving, yet they had directed them to use alternative routes. She said that they decided to forcefully close the road for works to start, and the works will last for about 3 weeks.
Because we have started works, we don't want any interruptions from traffic from either side, from Kisoro and Kabale.
However, residents called for faster construction works on the road to allow their businesses to continue functioning normally.
Now you see, we are stuck. We don't know how the government can help us, maybe shift the load, because there is a lot of water here. We had some trees around here, all got deep down. So now maybe we call upon the government to come and help us and shift the load. Because now, I think we shall keep on getting accidents around, because now, this has happened. You see, that hill there is all the soils from this road.
According to Wycliffe Rushanju, a tour operator at Gorillas and Beyond Safaris, also a proprietor of Bweza Gorilla Lodge, said the alternative route suggested might not be favorable for tourism businesses to prosper.
25 kilometers from here is Bwindi Impenetrable National Park, which has now been part of, only small cars can pass, and the alternative route that's being suggested goes, increases about 88 kilometers on the destination. For any tourism destination to work, 4 A's are important. One is access, 2 is activities and attractions. We have a major attraction here, but now the access to that attraction has been hampered.
Evelyn Ninsima Chikafunda, the founder of Green Environment Promotion, a local conservation organization in the region, attributes the disasters experienced lately to the improper soil and water management practices.
It is very evident that most of the roads that we are walking through, their drainage channels are not good enough, honestly. So when the water is quite a lot, definitely the roads will be washed away, which is evident on the Kabale Kisoro Road. And my prayer is that the team that we have to construct the roads will be very mindful, you know, on the basics of road construction to ensure that drainages are put in place.
Chigezi is among the regions across the country that are receiving heavy rains. The heavy rains have caused death of about 18 people in the districts of Rutshiga, Rubanda and Kisoro between the night of Tuesday and Wednesday this week. Report by Job Namanya for the news.